After the previous multi-layer exercise with structure, we will do this one again. And I'm going to make it more difficult now. I will show the most of what the machine can do in this exercise. And one of the disadvantages is we will have to do it in multiple times. I can't just click the print button once. I will have to do print upon print because I do special combinations of print files, which you can't combine in any software. So I will define a first layer as white. I will define a second layer as varnish and print the same image because I want my structure to build up as fast as possible. Then again, a white one combined with a varnish one, a color layer, and a varnish for the glossy varnish. So I will do six different layers. I will print this in three times. The advantage of an object printer is that if you don't touch your media, you can do print upon print upon print. So stay awake, bear with me, because this will be a difficult exercise, but you will learn a lot of how the machine functions. I want to feel the edges of my stamp, so I'm going to use this one to do structure. I add it, align to lower right corner. This is white ink. And here, I'll add it again, the same file, doesn't matter if it's cold white, for varnish. These two I will use to build up my first layer structure. I add this one to have the text in structure, again with white and varnish ink. So again, position identical. Varnish, position it identical, and then this will be followed by the color file. And finishing touch, we will add again the varnish. Varnish. I'll take this one. It's more impressive if the text as well is glossy. So six different layers. We'll send this all to the layer editor. Let me define my print modes. Fine. Let's hope it's working this time. I did predefine my layers before inserting the images. So large dot size, high density, high density. It's actually all I need. I will ignore the glossy. I will manipulate this with the layer editor as soon as I finish the importing all my files. I apply, send to layer editor all valid files. Here we go. This will take some time to preparing. Once they are all in here, we can start to assemble our images. So all my layers are inside my layer editor. And now I will start assemble them and show some advanced functions of the layer editor. So I clicked my change layer button, and the first I want to do were the edges of the stamp. I made a white and a varnish one, and I want to print as fast as possible, so I will not layer. I will mix the white and varnish together. So I get unlayered color white varnish. I don't have to use all three. Now it's just a matter of paying attention which ones are used. You could switch to icon for that. I just prefer to use the preview. So 1421. This was one of the white ink edges. I select this for white. And this was the other one. This one in varnish ink, although it has the name white, I use the same file. Varnish ink, I select. So close the preview. This is ready. As I said, build up as fast as possible. So I go to my expert settings and I select bidirectional, which was already there from the previous one. I would like to save this combination. Somebody else coming after me will have to redo the printing. So I will switch on the keep media set active. I don't have to push the up button to reload my table every time in that case. And I'll save this as a layer set. So this one is my queen stamp A, and that's white varnish underground one. So we use the A, so it's in alphabetical order. Save the export settings. So after I made the edges of my stamp, I want to have this text and the head of the queen. So this is white ink, select here, and one in varnish, yes, two in varnish actually. Second one over there, again to go as fast as possible and to print this on top of what is already printed. So I will save this one again. I do a layer set save, queen stamp B, underground white varnish. Number two, save this with the export settings. After this, we print the color file, which of course has to be some good quality. So I cancel these. I change my layer mode to color only, apply. And this was the color file. I select, don't need to leave anymore. And this one, since I want some good quality, I print in UNIDIR. The bidirectional is always a little bit, a little bit more off than the UNIDIR. The machine is made to print UNIDIR. We apply, and we will save a layer set. Queen stamp C, color UNIDIR. Save the export settings. We have that one too. Once the color file is finished, I would like to get some varnish on top of that, and to do so I might first need to explain, or I will explain afterwards, how the lamps are working, how you can control this this glossy and matte with the new six segmented lamp we have. So anyway, I'll just keep on preparing now. Varnish, I apply this one, and it is still active. I can double click since it is only one layer. Export settings, we'll switch this one back to bi-directional, and I will fiddle with my lamp settings. I will explain why I do this in a later phase, but this is one way to create glossy varnish. So use the lamps during printing. You see I have six segments, of which segment one and two are coming beyond the head. Segment 3, 4, 5, and 6 are in line with the head, and my head can use clockwise or counterclockwise. For the moment, this one, low power, and the others I will select to go in a very low power. Almost nothing, just enough to keep the ink together actually. I apply this one. And again, I save as a layer set. D, glossy varnish. Save export settings. And close the preview. So now, my colleague who is coming behind me, who has to do the printing, he can launch the four prints by just choosing the layer set and go A, B, C, D, one by one. So he remembers my previous settings. If I click on this one, here we go. Two files, unlayered, check the export settings, it will go bidirectional. Same for this one. If I take the color setting, I just double click, I get a color only printing, just one file. And if I check the export settings, will print UNIDIR. And last but not least, the glossy varnish launches the varnish file, and even remembers my special lamp settings which I have made and which I will explain in a later video. So starting from here, there are two more things we can do which are not in the layer set saved, and that's of course the keep media set active. This one is very important, so you don't have to reload the media every time. Also the copies. That one, I want a text structure, so let's make it 4 copies. Here we go. Print. The result after my 4 layers white and varnish. An impressive thick layer. So now my software will start with the image of the queen again in white and varnish to have even more structure, and then followed by the color. My first layers are finished. We will carry on by double clicking on Queen Stamp B and 4 times also print away. So we now finished our underground, 4 layers for the edge of the stamp and 4 layers of unlayered white and varnish for the structure of the head of the queen. It's looking fantastic actually. That's not bad at all. A very nice thick layer. So as my media set is active, the machine reloads automatically. The underground is finished. I select my layer set Queen Stamp C, which switches to the color printing in Unidir for the high quality. Now, pay attention, you don't need 4 layers of color. 2 perhaps if you want the color to be darker and stronger. That might be an option. I'll settle for 2 layers. The color is finished, and as a last part of this exercise, we will launch the glossy varnish printing in the new method, where lamp 6, 5, 4, and 3, so lamp 3, lamp 4, lamp 5, lamp 6, in both directions are set very low to enable the varnish to bleed open to create the glossy effect. Lamp 2 at 15%, lamp 1 at 100% for the finalized curing. 1 layer should be sufficient for the effect in this case. And print. We are talking less than half an hour time to create this. Let's just compare. This was the first one, so single layer color, a little bit of structure, a little bit of glossy varnish, but the second one. This is unbelievable. Too bad you cannot feel the thickness in the movie. I'm guessing something like nearly 1 millimeter at the thickest point. We'll be very close to 1 millimeter. I can let you hear the effect, and the glossy varnish, ooh, this feels so nice. This is a winner. So we are finished with our special structure, special glossy varnish. Whatever is in here, so my documents, which are of course linked to my layer sets, are currently in my spool folder. So the PRN are the RTL files. The previews which are created are the JPEGs, Dot are some the settings, the special settings coming from my layout tool, the ones you find in here. And when I make a layer set, you get these folders which have the name of the layer set, and inside are the XML files. So all of this will be available for you if you copy it into the same folder like I have, which is C double point backslash spool space 661. They will open in your layer editor, given the fact that you choose the same spool folder and that you of course have the same printer type installed, and you can just repeat whatever I have done here with the same settings, as a good exercise to get to know your machine. Furthermore, the settings I made here, so my layers, I will save this desktop queen stamp six layers, so that normally if I switch off my software and restart my software, is available to do the same exercise. So let me open this one. As you can see, it opens in a non-editable mode. So you see the layers. If you want to change something, you first have to remove the checkbox next to non-editable mode, and now you can change it. As soon as it's on non-editable, nothing can move. But same thing, you will get the file, and it will be a nice way to learn the software and get to know your machine.